Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. In this video, we will discuss Chapter 5, Class 10 Mathematics, Arithmetic Progression. Question number 4, Solution, Exercise 5.1. Which of the following are arithmetic progression? If they form an arithmetic progression, find the common difference D and write 3 more terms. So here they have given some list of numbers and we need to identify whether that is an arithmetic progression or not. And if it is an arithmetic progression, we need to find the common difference as well as 3 more extra terms we need to find out. So the first sub question 2, 4, 8, 16. So here first let us name this as first term, second term, third term, fourth term, A1, A2, A3, A4. We know that we can find the common difference by this way, A2 minus A1, that is 4 minus 2 gives 2, or A3 minus A2, 8 minus 4 gives 4, then A4 minus A3, 16 minus 8 is equal to 8. See here, you can observe we have got the common difference value, but all the values are different here. Common difference D is not same here. That means we can say that this list of number 2, 4, 8, 16 is not an arithmetic progression. To form an arithmetic progression, we have to get the same common difference. So this is not an arithmetic progression. Next, sub question 2, 2, 5 by 2, 3, 7 by 2. So here A1, A2, A3, A4. So first let us find the D value. D is equal to A2 minus A1, that is 5 by 2 minus 2. Here if I take the LCM as 2, 2 into 2 is 4. So 5 minus 4 divided by 2, that is equal to 1 by 2. Then D is equal to A3 minus A2, 3 minus 5 by 2, that is equal to LCM as 2, so 2 into 3, 6 minus 5 divided by 2, that is equal to 1 by 2. Then D is equal to A4 minus A3, 7 by 2 minus 3, so 2, so 7, 2 into 3 is 6, so 7 minus 6 divided by 2, that is equal to 1 by 2. In this case, we have got the same common difference in all the cases. So as the common difference D is same here, we can say the list of number 2, 5 by 2, 3, 7 by 2 is an arithmetic progression. Now as this is the arithmetic progression, we have to find out 3 more extra terms. So let us find out the next term. So to find the next term, see A5 means we can add the previous term with the D value. So the D forms the fixed number. By adding this D to the preceding number, we can get the next number. So that we know in the case of arithmetic progression. So now here we have 4 numbers. Next number is A5. So A5 is equal to A4 plus D. This is the previous number A4 plus D, that is the common difference. So A4 is nothing but 7 by 2, 7 by 2 plus D is half. So here we get 7 plus 1 divided by 2, that is equal to 8 by 2, that is equal to 4. Next, again we need the next number. So sixth number A6 is nothing but the preceding number A5 plus D. So A5 is 4, 4 plus half. So here you can take the LCM as 2, 2 into 4, that is 8 plus 1 divided by 2. We get the answer 9 by 2. Then seventh term A7 is equal to A6 plus D. A6 is 9 by 2 plus D is half. So that is equal to 9 plus 1 divided by 2, 10 by 2, 2 1s are, 2 5s are, that is equal to 5. So here we have got next 3 terms also, 4, 9 by 2 and 5. That means we can have the list of numbers in this way, 2, 5 by 2, 3, 7 by 2. These are the given values. Along with that, 3 more extra terms we have found, that is 4, 9 by 2, 5. Sub question 3, minus 1.2, minus 3.2, minus 5.2, minus 7.2. So first let us find the D value. So we will consider this as A1, A2, A3 and A4. So D is equal to -3.2. A2 minus A1 minus 3.2 minus A1, that is -1.2. Minus minus plus here, so -3.2 plus 1.2. -3.2 plus 1.2 means 2 minus 2, 0. Minus 3 plus 1, that is -2. We get the answer -2. Then D is equal to A3 minus A2 minus 5.2 minus -3.2. So this becomes plus, so -5.2 plus 3.2. 2 minus 2 is 0, minus 5 plus 3 is minus 2. So we get minus 2. Then D is equal to A4 minus A3 minus 7.2 minus minus 5.2, that is minus 7.2 plus 5.2. We get the answer here. 2 minus 2 is 0, minus 7 plus 5 is minus 2, so minus 2. In this case, we have got the same common difference in all the cases. That means the list of number minus 1.2, minus 3.2, minus 5.2, minus 7.2 forms an arithmetic progression. Now, as this is an arithmetic progression, we need to find out the three extra terms. So to find the terms, see, already we have four terms. So the fifth term is nothing but the constant term, that is the common difference D, plus the preceding term, so A4 plus D, that is equal to A4 is 7.2 here, minus 7.2 plus D is minus 2, so we get here minus 7.2 minus 2, that is minus 9.2. Then A6 is equal to A5 plus D minus 9.2 plus minus 2, that is minus 9.2 minus 2, that gives minus 11.2. Then A7 is equal to A6 plus D, that is equal to minus 11.2 minus 2, that is equal to minus 11.2 minus 2 minus 13.2. So we can have the sequence like this way: minus 1.2, minus 3.2, minus 5.2, minus 7.2, and the three more extra terms, minus 9.2, minus 11.2, minus 13.2. Sub question 4, minus 10, minus 6, minus 2 and 2. So first D value, let us name this one as A1, A2, A3 and A4. So D is equal to A2 minus A1 minus 6 minus minus 10. So that becomes minus 6 plus 10, that is 4. Then D is equal to A3 minus A2 minus 2 minus minus 6. So that gives minus 2 plus 6, that is equal to 4. Then D is equal to A4 minus A3, 2 minus minus 2. So that gives 2 plus 2, that is 4. So as here the common difference D is same in all the cases. So we can say the list of number minus 10, minus 6, minus 2 and 2 forms an arithmetic progression. Now this is an arithmetic progression, so we have to find out the three extra terms. So the next term, already we have your four terms. So fifth term, A5 is equal to A4 plus D. A4 is 2 here, 2 plus D is 4, 2 plus 4 is equal to 6. A6 is equal to A5 plus D. A5 is 6 here, so 6 plus 4, that is 10. A7 is A6 plus D. A6 is 10 here, 10 plus 4, that is equal to 14. So we can have the list minus 10, minus 6, minus 2, 2, 6, 10, 14. These are the three extra terms of this particular arithmetic progression. Sub question 5. 3, 3 plus square root of 2, 3 plus 2 square root of 2, 3 plus 3 square root of 2. So this is A1, A2, A3 and A4. So the first D value, A2 minus A1, 3 plus square root of 2 minus 3. So here 3 and 3 we can cancel, minus 3. So we get square root of 2. Then D is equal to A3 minus A2, that is 3 plus 2 square root of 2 minus 3 plus square root of 2. So this gives 3 plus 2 square root of 2 minus 3 minus square root of 2. So this 3 and minus 3 we can cancel. Then we have 2 square root of 2 minus, this is nothing but 1 square root of 2. So that gives the answer square root of 2. Then D is equal to A4 minus A3, 3 plus 3 square root of 2 minus 3 plus 2 square root of 2. That is 3 plus 3 square root of 2 minus 3 minus 2 square root of 2. This and this we can cancel. So we have 3 square root of 2 minus 2 square root of 2. That is nothing but square root of 2. In this case, the common difference is same. That means we can say these list of number forms an arithmetic progression. Now we have to find out three more extra terms. So A5 is equal to A4 plus D. A4 is 3 plus 3 square root of 2. D value is square root of 2. So we get here 3 plus 3 square root of 2 plus square root of 2. That is 3. Then here we can take this as 1. So 3 plus 1, that is 4. 4 square root of 2. Then A6 is equal to A5 plus D. A5 is 3 plus 4 square root of 2 plus D value square root of 2. So we get here 3. Then 4 plus 1, that is 5. So 3 plus 5 square root of 2. Then A7 is equal to A6 plus D. A6 is 3 plus 5 square root of 2. D is square root of 2. So we get here 3 plus 5 plus 1, that is 6. 3 plus 6 square root of 2. So we have the list as 3, 3 plus square root of 2, 3 plus 2 square root of 2, 3 plus 3 square root of 2, then 3 more extra terms, 3 plus 4 square root of 2, 3 plus 5 square root of 2, 3 plus 6 square root of 2. Then 6th sub question 0.2, 0.22, 0.222, 0.2222. So first let us find the D value. Let us name this one as A1, A2, A3 and A4. So D is equal to A2 minus A1, that is 0.22 minus 0.2. So 0.22 minus 0.2 means, see here 2, 2 minus 2, that is 0. So we get here 0.02. Then D is equal to A3 minus A2, that is 0.222 minus 0.22. So here we have 2, then 2 minus 2 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0, so we get here 0.002. Then D is equal to A4 minus A3, that is 0.2222 minus 0.222. That gives 2, 2 minus 2 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0, so 0.0002. So here the common difference is not same, that means we can say this list is not an arithmetic progression. Subquestion 7, 0, minus 4, minus 8, minus 12. D is equal to A2 minus A1. So here we have minus 4 minus 0, that gives minus 4. Then D is equal to A3 minus A2, that is minus 8 minus minus 4, that gives minus 8 plus 4, that is minus 4. D is equal to A4 minus A3, minus 12 minus minus 8, that gives minus 12 plus 8, that is minus 4. In this case, we have got the same common difference. That means the list 0, minus 4, minus 8, minus 12 forms an arithmetic progression. Now we have to find out three more extra terms. So the fifth term A5 is equal to the fixed number then plus the preceding term, that is A4. So A4 plus D. A4 is here minus 12 plus D is minus 4. Minus 12 minus 4, that gives minus 16. A6 is equal to A5 plus D, that is minus 16 minus 4, that is minus 20. A7 is equal to A6 plus D, minus 20 minus 4 is equal to minus 24. So we can have the list 0, minus 4, minus 8, minus 12, minus 16, minus 20, minus 24. These three are the extra terms. Next, sub question 8, minus half, minus half, minus half, minus half. So A1, A2, A3, A4. First, let us find the common difference D. D is equal to A2 minus A1. Minus half minus minus half. So this becomes minus half plus half. That gives 0. Then D is equal to A3 minus A2. Minus half minus minus half. That is minus half plus half. That is equal to 0. D is equal to A4 minus A3. Minus half minus minus half. That is equal to minus half plus half. That gives 0. See, in this case, you can observe we got the same common difference. That means we can say this list forms an arithmetic progression. As we got the same common difference and this is a arithmetic progression, we need to find out three more extra terms. So the next term, that is fifth term, is nothing but a5 is equal to a4 plus 3, that is nothing but a4 value is half here, minus half, so minus half, and d is 0, minus half plus 0, that is minus half. Then a6 is a5 plus 3, minus half plus 0, that is minus half. a7 is a6 plus 3, that is minus half plus 0, that is equal to minus half. So in this arithmetic progression, all the terms are same, we get minus half only for all the terms. Thanks for watching.